welcome back to the channel. In this video I'm gonna talk about the past events that happened last weekend. Last weekend we had lots of kickboxing events, controversies,
and
way more. We had some very big fights. We had Buakaw, who came back to fight against Yoshihiro Kido. We had Glory 88 with that was also very controversial, with Badr Hari against McSweeney, and UFC, where Strickland became UFC champion. And last but not least, K-1 was back. I made a video about this 2 months ago, about K-1 being back. And last weekend it was finally the time for K-1 to be back. And I also want to thank all the people that are watching my videos and comment on them. I really appreciate it. Most people are very loyal to me and I really appreciate that. And because of the comeback of K-1, I also had the idea to do a giveaway for you all. And that was to give away signed Peter Aerts K-1 cards. And I'm gonna talk about that later in the video, so you have to keep watching. Okay, first I wanted to talk about UFC 293. The reason that I'm gonna start about this is that the most people are for kickboxing on my channel, and yeah, this has to do the least with kickboxing. So UFC 293 had a crazy end result, because Israel Adesanya, who is also a kickboxer, who fought in Glory and other organizations, especially in China, he lost the title against Sean Strickland, the underdog, and this is one of the craziest upsets in history of the UFC, I think. And it's crazy because one of the biggest upsets before that was also there, when Ronda Rousey fought against Holly Holm and got knocked out by a high kick. And the event overall was very great, so it was crazy, and congratulations to Sean Strickland. The second event we're gonna talk about was RWS. Yoshihiro Kido was fighting against Buakaw, and this fight ended in a no contest by a headbutt, an accidental headbutt. I did not really see the fight for the rest, but I think Buakaw gave him an 8 count, or at least hurt him in the first round. But that ended in a no contest, and I think Buakaw was winning that fight. I've just seen some highlights of it, so that's all I can say about that. Okay, so we're gonna talk about Glory 88 right now, and this event was very questionable, and that is because of Badr Hari. Let's first talk about the rest of the card, because I don't think really the card was that special. We had 3 big fights where I want to focus on. The first one is Stefan Latescu, who made his Glory debut, and he fought perfectly. He really dominated his opponent, and the fight could have been better because of the opponent. The opponent was clinching all the time and was trying to make it a Muay Thai fight, but this is kickboxing, and really killed the action a lot. And Stefan did a really good job, and could have even gotten the finish, but his opponent still stood there. And who is next for Stefan Latescu? I think he can also become one of the youngest Glory champions in light heavyweight. I'm very curious what he's gonna do after this fight, because there are a lot of great matchups. So let me know in the comments who you think that Stefan should fight next. The second fight was Tiffany Van Soest against Sarah Mussatak. Tiffany Van Soest had her last fight, and at the age of 34, her last kickboxing fight, and she knocked out Sarah Mussatak with a beautiful high kick that Sarah was really gone. She stood up, but she was not recovering on time, so very good performance for her, and good for her to end her career with a victory. And last but not least, Badr Hari against McSweeney. Badr Hari, 10 minutes before his fight, he cancelled it, and he did that because of the Moroccan earthquake, or the earthquake in Morocco. The thing is, everybody has their opinion about it. Some people think it's really good and some people think it's horrible. My opinion is that I think he should have still fought, or at least let know the people beforehand, before the event, because he knew already before that he was not going to fight. Because many people come for him everywhere around the world, and then he cancels the fight. So many people came for him, and that was really disappointing to see that he's not fighting. I can understand he's not fighting for the people, but there were also lots of other fighters with Moroccan origin that still fought and put up a great performance. And I think, in my opinion, my humble opinion, I think that would be better for the Moroccan earthquake and for Morocco to fight the fight and then donate his money to Morocco and all the victims. That's what I think would be the perfect solution for everybody. And I don't know what Glory is gonna do, if they're gonna reschedule this fight or just gonna leave it like it is. Yeah, I really don't know what's next for Badr Hari. What do you guys think? Please let me know in the comments. I'm really curious what you guys think. And now we go to the event I was talking about for a while now. K-1 Rebirth, or Reboot, however you want to call it. It was an 8-man tournament, and it was a very surprising tournament. Yeah, the first fight on the card was Claudio Istrate against Mahmoud Sattari. Mahmoud Sattari is my teammate and friend, and sadly he lost the first fight. And as you could tell, Mahmoud Sattari is 83 kilos and his opponent was 107 kilos, so it was a little mismatch and you could really tell the difference in weight. It's crazy because Mahmoud is a natural middleweight, so he would kill everybody in his weight class, but he always fights on minus 90 in the K1 and now on heavyweight and everything. The second fight was Sina Karamean against Karim Jamai. This fight was also a little, this one was really debatable because Sina gave the German some nut shots and still managed to knock him down twice in the third round, which gave him the TKO victory. Third fight was Turinski against Machado, and Machado won this by unanimous decision. Four rounds of fighting, so that was really hard for Machado to already start the tournament with a four-round decision. And the Romanian Valentin Bordianu fought against Liu Che, who was like the surprise of the tournament because nobody really knew Liu Che. And Chinese fighters are not really known to be heavyweights. And especially, I think that's the first heavyweight fighter I know from Chinese origin. And he won the fight by first round knockout. In the second round, the semifinals, Claudio Istrate was fighting against Sina. And I think this was the most horrible, most unsportsmanlike fight I've ever seen. Sina hit him like 10 times on the back of the head. He gave him like 3 nut shots, and I really thought it was very unsportsmanlike to fight like this. And in the first round, Sina got an 8 count, received an 8 count, but I think that was very debatable because he was not really out. And he wasn't really hurt because he recovered immediately. But in the second round he got a minus point. And I think it was for hitting in the back of the head or for the multiple nut shots he gave, because it also took a very long time to start the fight again. I think that fight took around like 30 minutes just of waiting. And not to forget that the referee got knocked out by Sina, which is horrible. Like, after the bell, the referee was trying to get the fighters out of each other, and Sina hit the referee and then walked away. His trainer Niklas Petters immediately apologized to the referee, and after that I think they changed. But I don't think this has been a very good part from Sina. who is the cruiserweight champion, even though he never defends his belt. But yeah, Claudio Strate was dead in the third round, and Cena easily won that round. But yeah, 2-10-8 rounds in the first and second round, so that means he's losing. And the second fight was Ariel Machado against Liu Che. And this fight also ended very quick. Liu Che knocked him out in the second round. And yeah, Machado had a very hard fight before, but Liu Che really surprised everybody and also managed to win this fight by knockout. And then we go to the final. The final was Claudio Estrade again against Liu Che, and this fight took 30 seconds. Liu Che gave him 3 or 4 calf kicks and it was immediately over for the Italian. And yeah, Liu Che is the new K-1 champion. I would have never expected him to win the tournament, and that is because I didn't know him before. But it's great to see a Chinese heavyweight fighter. Also on this card we saw Mikio Ueda, a Kyokushin world champion in the heavyweight, make his K-1 debut and his kickboxing debut, and what a fight. He really dominated his opponent, Keiji. Yeah, I've trained a few times with Mikio Ueda, and he's a really nice guy and he's really strong. He's I think my height and he's 115 kilos, and yeah, his kicks are really good. And I think if he can get 2 or 3 more kickboxing fights in and gets used to kickboxing, then he's gonna be a huge problem to the kickboxing world. In the award ceremony, my father was there too with my sister, but my father had to present the trophy to the third place in the tournament. I think also to Claudio, so the second place too. So he gave the trophy to Machado, to Cena, and he gave it to Estrade. And it was very funny because after this, a clip went viral of my father, or not even of my father, of a ring girl that saw my father in the ring. Yeah, so that was a very funny response of the girl that she already clarified on Instagram that she was really shocked to see my father and did not expect it. So yeah, that's really funny to see. And yeah, it had millions and millions of views on multiple channels, so it was really funny to see, because I was just opening my Twitter or X or whatever you call it, and the first thing I saw was that video. Alright, and now I'm going to do the giveaway. It's not exactly these cards, but apart from this, my father has signed some cards and they will look like this. Let me quickly show you guys. My father will sign these cards, and let me quickly show them. These are a few cards my father will sign, and I'm gonna do a giveaway. And the conditions for the giveaway are, for YouTube, you have to be subscribed to me, you have to like the video, and you have to comment down below why you want to win these cards. For Instagram, you have to send me a DM that you are subscribed to my YouTube channel. When you join the giveaway, you get a few cards and a few people can win. Anyway, thank you all for watching the video. If you're not subscribed yet, subscribe. Yeah, if you still want to join the giveaway, go back to the video and check the screen, because there I put it a little bit easier to see. And yeah, I hope to see you in the next video.